The woman with the issue of blood, what I've learned from her is really that everybody has an issue. And the most significant thing that I take away from her story is not the fact that we all have issues, but how we are to resolve those issues. I'm so inspired and encouraged by her story. You know, she just bled, and she had an issue of blood for many, many years, and she spent all of her money on doctors and trying to figure out what was wrong, and nobody could tell her. And when she's at her wit's end, she finds out that Jesus is in town, and she presses her way through the crowd, and the Bible is crystal clear. It says she touched the hem of his garment and was made whole. And I just think that that is just so inspiring to know that he has that much power. Christ is awesome, and I think a lot of times as Christians, we really downplay his power, and we put him in a box, and we, you know, well, God really can't do this for me, or he's really not going to do that for me. And, you know, it's like, where is our faith? Where is our faith? Where was the woman with the issue of blood? Where was her faith? She knew that Christ could do it, so she pressed her way on in there, touched the hem of that garment, and was made whole. So where is my faith? Where is my faith as a Christian to think that, you know, God is not going to do something or God can't do anything? The Bible is crystal clear with telling us that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. And we just gotta believe. We really have to believe, and we have to put everything into believing him and trusting him and having faith to know that he's gonna do what he said he's gonna do, and that he's able.
Wherever the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There is liberty. You can be free. You can be free. Lift your hands if you believe it, and if you know you can be free.